Hey everybody, Outdoor Detective here. Welcome back. We are at the 2023 Camaro Nationals being held at the Holiday Inn in Morgantown, Pennsylvania. Looking at all the parts available here. Heads, intakes, crank, seats. More carburetors. Even selling some Tremec transmissions here. A little bit of food here. Smells good. All right, I think I'll start as far away as I can. Everybody's sitting in the shade. These are all the Hot Wheels collections.
Like everyone's attention, we're missing a pink iPhone from the Baloney restroom. It's pink in a clear case. He's bringing a video CC tag. We need so on a rate. Thank you.
Sorry. Bumblebee version from Transformers. And now I gotta keep talking because of the music. It's gonna drive me nuts. Wow. I'm gonna say he races this with it being tubbed out and caged. Of Firebirds here. 69. It's got the 400 in it? Oh, the 455, 400 horse. One beside us is a 67. Appears to be a lot more cars here this year than last year. 67. Very nice. Manual shift.
Song number two.
Obviously not the original motor. Looks pretty good. Long tubes. Another 67. Here is the owner, 610-223-5450. This car is for sale. He's got a number 40,000 on it. It is the T-handle 67, 68, and 69. They went to the basket handle. Number 67 here. Sharp looking.
They made a color that matches.
Named Betsy. Small block 327, 69, SS, automatic on the column. I don't know if that's original, because that interior looks like it's green, so that may not be the original, unless I look at the cow tag. Well, it says it's supposed to be black vinyl. Might just be a little bit faded. Carpet looks green too. I don't know. Wow, that's nice. Really nice. Small block, 5.7 or 350. Gen 2. Very nice looking. 79 maybe? I'm on a manual shift yet. Camel interior, type LT. Gen 4. Strange look to them, although the Gen 4s, I think they put a little more horsepower into them. They got a little more engine. Wow. That's got a lot going on. Supercharged. Mostly late models. Oh, there's a Gen 3. Well, an IROC Z. Is that early 80s for an IROC? Oh, he worked on that. That's definitely not that standard 305. Oh, it's an 88. Late 80s. New gauge cluster, probably to go with that engine, but. I had one of these, and I didn't care for it. I mean, it was an okay car, but the third gen just wouldn't get out of its own way.
you want to take a break?
A lot of motor for a little car, huh?
Oh, it is, yeah, for sure.
You see the cow tag? See the,
I guess it is.
I got too much stuff dangling on me. I don't want to do that to someone's vehicle. Another Gen 4. A couple of them here. '69. Looks like it should be an SSRS package, but no covers. It's definitely cooler walking around the grass. Last year I didn't show very much of the Gen 3s and Gen 4s, and I heard about it. But I did explain in the beginning that I'm a Gen 1 fan, period. But this one appears to be well taken care of. Manual shift, 67 here. Huge big block in there. RS. Gen 2 here. Very nice. '72, 350. I like the 70, 71, 72, that gen with the front end. They put 427 badging on it for a 69 SS. Did some work on this one. Houndstooth interior, basket handle automatic. Very nice. There are quite a few Firebirds here. It's a GM F body, so there it's the cousin to the Camaro. In fact, I think some of the sheet metal even matches. $400. That's nice looking. Z28. I can't tell if it's an X. I can't see it. I'll look at that later. See what the X code is, see if it's an original X77 car. Good looking. As all Z28s are. I've been told something, and I'm not sure if that's accurate. the ball of the shifter should not have the 1, 2, 3, 4 reverse on it if it's on the center console. It's not a double thing. And I think this car actually has it, if we can see that. We'll go back and look at it. Yeah, see, it's on the console, but it's also on top of the shifter knob. I was told that that's not original. I am not sure of that. Hey, Parker from Backyard Barn Finds, maybe you can tell me. All right, we looked at these. Let's go to the next row. Wow. I don't know if that's an original. That was done by, not the factory, but by the dealer. Ooh, that's got a lot going on. Good looking 69. X33 car. And an X77 car. Wow, nice looking. A lot of motor there. Big manual shift. 1973 here. Oh, sorry.
No, no problem.
This one yours?
Yeah.
Nice.
Thank you.
You do all that work?
Some of it. Some of it I didn't. Some of it I did. Put the motor in and stuff, but the car was, I did a lot, probably 50%.
Oh? Yeah, sharp, and I love black cars. Wow. Orange houndstooth interior, isn't that something? Can't say I've seen one like that. '68. For those that don't know, the rectangular running lights and missing the wing window. Two easy ways to tell that it's a '67 or '68. Oops, sorry. Tremendous amount of Gen 4s and 5s this year, and later models. Look at that, 69, it's beautiful. Wow, a lot of work in this one.
Say happy.
Big block, resto modded. Wow, a lot of work on that. Lots of work. Now I gotta deal with that again, so I apologize. I'm just gonna walk by the cars and I'll probably have to take out the sound. So here I took out the soundtrack due to that loud background noise, and I don't want to get dinged for some form of copyright violation. So here we're just going to walk right by all the cars in the front row before we actually enter the building. Here you're looking at a really nice 69 SS. This was a really good looking car. Somebody put a lot of time into this one. Very impressed. I think it's a 68 we're looking at there, manual shift. Really good looking car. Like I said previously, there's a lot more cars here this year than there were last year. Probably double the amount of cars, or at least near double the amount of cars. Nice 69. 68 is the white one. That's a resto modded 69. Wow. And the red one. Look at an LS motor in there. This silver and black one's sharp looking. Z28 trim on that one. 45.5 they want for that. I don't like the wheels. And I think it's blue, not black. 396. Oh, big block. All right, we're going to go find the concourse cars. Now it says it's a 70 Chevelle SS454. I'm going to doubt that that's a LS6. That's not an original. I'm pretty sure Patrick Glenn Nichols would tell us whether or not it is. All right, here we go. We're inside. These are the exhibition halls. These are the concourse vehicles.
Gold prototype one.
Yep, we're recording. And we're recording. Automatic on the column. If there's information about each one, I'll see if I can give it to you. Whoops. I'm recording a camera, So a 69 pace car. This is an automatic on the column car, SS with the RS package. You can see that it's on the column. 69 Z10. So it's a real pace car here. Z10 car. I think the Z11s were the convertibles. Got a good look with the GoPro. Antique. Very nice car. Gen 4 Z28. Yeah.
That's
They were last year in actually one of the groups, either I think it was Lehigh Valley. They took it and linked it to their website.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah, I caught some hell for not showing enough Gen 3s. I said in the beginning, hey, I'm a pure Gen 1 fan.
As am I, by the way. My other car is a 69 Camaro, so.
Oh, good for you.
My modern car is this one.
Why am I stuck here?
You're just looped. That's
Can
it.
You undo me? There we go. You have a 69?
I have a 69 convertible. It's got like that one right there.
Nice. Okay.
But they wanted this one. As far as I know, they've never had a Neiman Marcus here.
That's nice. It's very different. It doesn't match anything else.
Yeah, I've been getting a lot of love.
It looks like beginning of the fifth gen. Was it 2010, 11,
12? That's what I love about it. The fifth gen is a homage to the first gen. And so when you
headlights,
put these two
rear
next
end.
To each other, better. That's why in my garage I have both of them, because they're just such a... And I don't want to keep you from your work.
No. How about it? I'm learning.
When I saw this, it was, you know, I just had to have it. It was like, I found it used. It was on Car Gurus, of all places.
Really?
Yeah, and I was like, looking for a different modern Camaro, and this metallic plum tan leather car pops up. I'm like, what the hell is this?
I got to see this.
And so I was the first phone call. They had 20 offers that week for this car.
Wow.
So I got lucky, very lucky.
So this is the, what's in this, LS3?
It's... I want to say...
Like 450?
Let me look. L99. L99, 6.2.
Yeah, what's the... Did it say the horsepower?
400.
Oh, okay. I was right on that.
Yeah.
Yep. That makes it drivable. Very drivable. Yeah. User-friendly.
Yeah, it was a blast coming here. Although, it's a debate whether I'm ever going to drive it like that again. It'll be trailered probably.
How far was your run?
Ohio.
Oh, okay.
Because
that was
I had to deal with all the to drive
turnpike
it,
traffic.
No problem. But the tractor trailers.
And they don't give a shit. They drive like assholes on the turnpike.
And that's the problem. And I got lucky there were no stones thrown my way, but I don't know that I want to take that chance again.
And
but for this is a major big deal. I'll do it.
Well, it's not like you want to wrap it either, the front of it, to protect it, because then it looks different when it's wrapped.
Yeah. Oh, no. I did wrap it just to come here.
Yeah.
I took it right off.
Okay.
But it's a blast, and I just was very lucky to find it. Do you know Scott Settlemyer, who is one of the speakers here?
No,
He was one of the Chevy execs. He came to Ohio when we had our Fall Classic, and he ended up picking it over like 160, 170 Camaros.
It's just totally different. Many of them, you kind of get a gist of what they're all like.
Yeah.
Whether they're modded up a little bit or painted fancy or
their own unique
supercharged.
Personality.
Yeah, but this is completely different. It caught my eye.
Yeah, I was thrilled. And then, you know, you don't know what you have, and so you start doing homework. And it turns out.
Or doing shows, and then people are talking to you.
I found out I was the only one in our membership that has one, and we have a lot of members. And then I found out I don't think they've ever had one here. And I had a guy at a car show 3 weeks ago. He goes, comes up to me.
How much you want for?
Well, he comes, no, not yet. But he comes up to me and he goes, I had to seek out one of these for my wife. We have one in our garage.
Oh.
He goes, I want you to know I'm a collector. He goes, sit on this.
So he's one of the other 75.
Yeah. Well, he sought it out for his wife. And she has it in the garage. And
take care of it, protect it.
And he told me, he goes, I collect cars, and I'm looking for ones that are going to take off. And he goes,
that's one
sit
of them.
On this. And so, you know, you hear this stuff. I don't know him from Adam. I don't even know his name. But you hear these things.
Well, I mean, all the Gen 1s, if it's a really nice car, they're out of reach for the normal working man. They can't
now
afford them.
Now they are, yeah.
Yeah, they can't afford them.
No. And these are such, I still think that's the most beautiful car ever made. I don't think there's any car above it in any league, anywhere.
Give me some. I'm with you on that one. I appreciate that.
69 Camaros.
Absolutely.
Holy shit, they're just pure heaven. When I finally got mine, I just couldn't get over the fact it was in my garage. You know, it's one of those things.
They did the lines right.
Oh.
I mean, they were trying to beat up on the Mustang, but this was a totally different deal when they engineered it, the lines on it. I mean, it has some mechanical issues, the axle wrapping, the problems like that, but...
But the exterior, the look of it is pure perfection.
Absolutely. And it doesn't matter if it's SS, RS, the combination.
Enjoy the car.
Yes.
There are so many want them, and there's so few of them to go around.
Originally, 20,000 Z28s, yeah. And now there's probably 100,000.
Yeah. Yeah, no kidding. So what do you do? What is your job?
Nothing with the car.
Are you working for them, or are you a freelancer?
I do all my stuff myself because I enjoy Camaros, and I just put it on YouTube, and then the next thing you know, I'm getting all kinds of emails. People enjoy it, so.
Because I'm a documentary photographer.
There you go.
I do long-term storytelling projects. So I always get it when somebody's got a passion for, you know, stills or video, and they're telling stories, you know.
I try to tell as much as I can about each one, or that when you have this, I'll stop and film it. So the people, if they want to read it, they can literally stop the video and read it.
I had to do this because people have no clue what this car is without. No, they don't. They don't. They truly.
They know it's different.
I wouldn't know. So I had to, you know, see that catalog above it?
Absolutely.
It's the only way you could buy it.
Really?
That's where it came from.
Wow.
It was never available in a dealership. It came from a catalog.
Wow.
It made an announcement on the Today Show, and all 100 cars sold in 180 seconds. Through the Neiman Marcus catalog. They have the Christmas book.
Well,
that's why that catalog's up there.
Well,
that's,
you know why? Because people that got them, now they know they got something because nobody else is going to have it. You're not going to find them on the streets. You're not going to find it sitting in a dealer. It's just not going to be around.
20 minutes ago, I was talking to a guy who said I was on the list for this car. He goes, "You have no idea how many of us did not get this." He goes, "I'm one of the people who didn't get it." He said, "Everything you said here is accurate." He goes, "That's where it came from. That's how fast it sold. Only 75 were made." And he said, "I was one of the people who didn't get it. I was one of the people who was
now you know
home.
You got to sit on it."
And so he said, you know, it's unusual to see them. A lot of them are in museums now.
You have children?
No.
Oh.
And that's going to be interesting, isn't it?
Oh, boy.
Who gets it?
Yep. Where's it going to go?
You know what my...
Because you got to it's got to be somebody that's going to enjoy it like you did take care of
you
it.
You know what my feeling is? You'll find this interesting. I'm toying with the idea of giving it to someone like you or somebody who's going to love it. At a certain point in the end of my life, it's not going to be about the money. Who's
no, it's the passion for the cars.
Who's going to take care of the car?
Absolutely about the passion for the cars.
It could be my mechanic. I don't have anybody in my family who has an interest in it. So it's going to be...
Why are there no men anymore? Like, where's the young men? They're like, they all wear skinny jeans.
I was just talking about the fact that I am such a boy now. All I care about is rock and roll music,
cars,
and sports.
Yep, burnouts.
I am your common, everyday American man.
And now they want to sit on their phone. There's no car guys. These young kids aren't car guys.
Although, be careful, because some of these young kids, they might be into their, you know, foreign
cars.
They're
tuner
right
cars.
Now.
Yeah.
I have a feeling that's going to morph into these cars eventually if they can afford it. They can't afford these cars. They can't.
Well,
they don't have that kind of money. They can't get it.
There's something about a turboed four-cylinder compared to naturally aspirated V8. You put them beside one another and start them. Which one are you going to gravitate to?
I guess.
There is no doubt that bumblebee, you're going to be like, eh. Real men are going to go to the V8 naturally aspirated. Well, fuel injected too, but that has a different sound. But that 69?
I brought mine to a car show, and I had a 17-year-old say, "This is my dream car." I said, "You have to sit in it."
Wow.
And I
a 17-year-old.
Yeah. And he said,
"Is Dad a car guy?"
I don't know, but he said, "Yeah, I said you could. You're welcome to sit in it. Just don't touch the shifter." And he said, "You're gonna let me sit in?" I said, "Yeah." He goes,
"Wow.
Hell yeah! You're the next generation. Get in that car, man. Feel it."
You get a picture of him?
Not him, but
oh,
I have
okay.
a picture of my '69. That's what it looks like. A black, all black convertible.
Mm-hmm. The tuxedo black is very, very limited in the number of cars that were made.
Yeah, that's not an original paint job.
And,
but
it's still an
shit.
Original color.
Yeah,
right?
It's tuxedo black, yeah.
But, yeah, there's very few of them. What I didn't know is that I found out talking to a Chevy guy is it didn't matter if it was, especially Dodge, but all three of the big manufacturers back in the late 60s did not like black cars. They didn't want to paint them black because why? They showed all the defects. That's why they had to spend extra time.
Every time I talk to somebody, I learn something.
Yeah, I didn't know that either.
That makes a lot of sense, though.
Yes, that's why you'll find, especially Dodge, is very, very limited.
But the huge miss on that is that only a few cars wear black beautifully.
Yes.
It's a very unforgiving, that is the best version.
Oh.
I mean, my car, when I've got it clean, I just stare at it. Certain cars do not, like modern cars, like a Subaru or whatever, a Toyota, they don't wear black. They just don't. I own one. They don't wear black.
Yeah.
But you get into a car that has style, that has lines.
The way the light hits it.
Oh.
I'm totally with you.
Yeah, I have. It's all black. It's a convertible, and it's got the white hot.
Now, do you drive yours, or you trailer it?
No, I drive it.
Good for you.
I drive all my cars.
Got
it. But I don't know that I want to take this on the road again because we talked about this. So if I ever end up trailering, it's only because I want to take care of it.
Yeah.
It's not that I don't drive them. I do.
Well, no. Driving like around the area of.
I do that every day, all the time.
I can understand that. But you put on a big road, too many things can happen.
Yep.
Put it in a box, get it there nice and safe. Now you can drive it around. Yeah.
That's my goal.
Yeah.
And so I'm looking for. I don't think my wife's going to let me buy a trailer because she doesn't want to have to look at it. I get it.
Get an open trailer with a nose cone.
So what I may do is find somebody I can
rent
from or borrow.
Yeah.
And then just, you know, trailer it from there.
I like the open trailers with the nose cone, because otherwise a box trailer they're hard to get in and out of. You got to squeeze down the side unless they got the open side.
I'm navigating toward too. If I cover it, if I cover the car, and I have that nose cone, I think I'm okay.
Yep.
In any elements. So
absolutely.
That's actually where I think I'm headed.
And you can get in and out. You can take care of it. You can look at it while it's on the trailer. Look for anything.
Yep.
Just being in a box is tough, and then you don't feel like getting it in and out of the box. Because it's a pain in the ass. Now, some guys put their cars in the box, like, well, I went to that show, and it's just still in. It's sitting in his trailer because it's a pain in the ass to get in and out. So, till the next show, which is 6 months later, then he'll take it to the show.
Oh, no, I drive my car.
That's.
I can't wait to get in my car.
Like, I come down here just to look at the cars.
Me too.
Because
I'm in a good mood right now, just looking at all the cars. I'm serious. I came out this morning when no one was here just to take it in myself.
My wife is not a car person at all.
Nor is mine.
She absolutely enjoyed coming here looking at the cars
Seriously.
That she grew up with. Absolutely loved it. She asked when, hey, you want to go down to the car place again? Now, she's doing something
That's
with
hilarious.
Her sister today. Last year, she actually helped me film. I said, here, I'm going to give you a camera. What I want you to do is go to each car that you like, say the year of the car, the engine that's in it, and the transmission. She didn't say shit. She just showed the cars. So I had to dub
that's
a music track over it.
That's my journey to find this car. She didn't want to sit in an old car. So she loves cruising. She has her own hat, her own music. She loves cruising. But she doesn't want to do it in that old car. She wants to achieve. So she said, a new one. Get me a newer one.
I'd be like, here, I'm going in that one.
That's the one I cruise in. But I've grown to love this car. Yes, it's a really unusual car.
Yeah.
Just a quickie, the only way you could buy that car was through that catalog.
Really?
Yeah, you want to see it? It's really
neat. No.
Is this your car?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
That's what I said.
Another 69, 396, big block. Manual, console, gauges. Gen 3. They called this, I believe it was called tune port injection, TPI. That's a good looking car. I like that car.
Can't be that bad. I'm sitting next to me, right? You know, right?
No, there's a bad deal.
pro touring setup, made for cruising. Manual shift, caged. A lot of specs. I don't know if you can see them or not. That there is all engine, no nonsense. So 69 Z28. Seats are not original, no console. Really good looking car, wow. Beautiful car. See if that's a, what the code is. See if we can see that. Not sure what that front end is. Definitely different. Looks like he's using pistons as cup holders. That's a great idea. Very nice. Very, very nice car. You're all good. You're all good. Wow. 1,700 miles. Wow. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Nice car. Crazy good looking car. 1970 Olympic gold. Four speed. How you doing?
How are you?
Doing all right. Who's the owner? You, the owner?
No? No, Dave's not here. He just said, stay by the car. Anybody touch it, kills him.
I can appreciate that. Good for him. They're paying me to put it out there to advertise it?
No, we already got it out there. We have copyright.
67 RS. Straight six. See part of that build sheet there, the options. Automatic on the column. Wow, what a beautiful car. A 1969 SS396 car. Automatic. '67. Trying to sell it. Driven less than 2 miles since its restoration. All original drivetrain, all matching numbers, date coded components, 89.9. Small block, 327, air conditioning. That's original, wow. '68 Z28, 302 in it. That same 68 Z28.
Oh. Yeah.
Wow. Fabulous paint. Four speed. Color is fantastic. I do not think that's an original color, but boy, is that nice. Wow. 2002 SS. Convertible. Manual shift. Beautiful. Another 69 Z28. Two fours. Again, dealer installed, not factory installed. I believe the intake was put in the trunk. If you can see it from the glare. Wow, two fours on it, 69, Z28. Yeah, that's definitely modded up a little bit. Motor. That's a true 555. Holy Jesus. Wow. That car is absolutely beautiful. Wow. Wow, this thing ran 9.9. I think this room I walked into is all first gen. L78, 396 apparently. Sure that this original drivetrain interior sheet and they just blew it up. I'm gonna have to look at that real close. You're the owner of this?
Yes, sir.
Oh my God. I'm impressed. Lucky you.
Thanks.
One of only a few.
I kind of like it.
I think I would too. I'd have to put a cage around, not let anybody near it. That is nice. You have it?
Let everybody enjoy it.
You have it from original?
Pardon?
You have it from original?
No, I wasn't old enough to buy it new.
Okay.
I'm the seventh owner, actually, but the original owner still lives 20 miles from me.
No kidding.
He had the window sticker. It's been around our hometown all its life.
Oh, my God.
It was street raced heavily.
Well, I could imagine.
Early days.
Yeah. The Holy Grail you're looking at here. Incredibly nice. It's good for you, man. This is the one you always look for, you try to find, and now I'm looking at one going, wow.
That's original paint, original interior, original drive paint. It's got 34,000 miles.
The value of that car is out of this world. Absolutely out of this world. I hope you have children. That's where it's going to go.
I have a son, I guess.
And he's a car guy?
He's a car guy.
Okay. That means he's going to keep it.
Yes.
Wow. Good for you. Absolutely good for you.
I've had a ball with it.
I could only imagine.
I bought the car in 85 and chased it for 11 years prior to that. And then a friend of mine ended up, I was never the right guy in line.
Yeah.
And a friend of mine ended up with it. He's a big bucker and had a bunch of cars. Well, I wrenched on his cars. I weld for a living, but this is my passion.
With you?
So I wrenched on his cars. Well, I got the wrench on this, but I couldn't own it. But he told me, he said, look.
Someday.
If I ever sell the car, you own it. And he made good on his promise in 85. And I rebuilt the motor in 86. I was tired. But amazingly, everything under the hood was still there. Every little piece except the exhaust manifolds. Oh. It had headers on it.
Day two stuff, yes, that happens.
Right. But every original carb, distributor, intake heads, block, all that, all still there. The solenoids for the fast idle and the kick down for the automatic, still there. You know.
You never find them.
No. Nobody's put them there at all. I've known all the owners. One of them told me, he said, the only thing I tried was a different carburetor and it ran terrible because I bolted the original carb right back on.
A very, very special car. In history of just an absolute. Wow. Now, you trailer to get it here.
Oh, yeah.
I
live in Springfield, Ohio.
Oh, so highway damage and shit. You don't want any of that.
No, it's rare now that it gets driven. I will drive it to a local show.
No.
You know, if it's
fired up a little bit.
Yeah, because of, you know, but you're buying race fuel. But it gets about 6 or 7 miles a gallon. Mm-hmm. And then you worry about the idiot that runs.
You can't control everybody else.
Right. So.
You're almost scared to drive it because of other people.
Yeah. I mean, I'm careful where I go, and I'm really watchful at any intersection. But it gets driven less now.
Get a lot of thumbs up when you're driving it, or if you do?
Yeah.
A lot of old guys like us.
The young guys don't even know what it is, you know.
They're into that nonsense, that tuner shit that just. I was just talking to a gentleman over there. He was telling me his story, too. And I asked him if he had family for his car, and he says, I don't. Like, oh, what a shame. He says it'll go to somebody that can appreciate it, like my mechanic or somebody else that has the passion.
Yeah.
And I said, these young kids, first of all, the young kids aren't men anymore. They're just not. I said, but you take a V8 naturally aspirated car next to a tuner, start them both up and see where people walk.
Yeah. Yeah, this thing barks. It's got a
oh my
nice
God.
Deep tone.
Yeah, you just.
Doesn't sound like a change.
Yeah, that's not my thing. Well, I appreciate it. Good luck with that thing, man.
Thanks.
Very nice. Very nice. These are some really valuable cars in here. 68 Z28. Oh, Jerry McNeish owns this. These are some really valuable cars in here. 68 Z28. Oh, Jerry McNeish owns this. Thank you. 100 miles, factory headers, cowl plenum, 488 gears. Wow. This is your car?
Yes.
Very, very nice. What's the item in the console?
That's
the stereophonic thing?
Tape player.
I've never seen that before.
Yeah. Very rare.
Wow. And you're Jerry?
Yes.
Oh, nice to meet you. Your gentleman writes a lot of articles.
Okay.
I read a lot of your stuff.
Oh, thank you.
You're apparently the man to go see when you want to know something. But this is impressive. There's a couple of cars here. Very impressive cars.
Yeah, it's a nice thing to put together.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, good luck with this. Appreciate the information you put out there to everybody. I'm just saying hello to Jerry McNeish there, the Camaro guru. There are so many cars here. Oops. Oh, the Enduro bumper this has. That means it's painted body color. It's not chrome. Build sheet. Wow. Oh my God. To have cars of this quality. Wow. I'm having, just because of the sheer volume of people, I'm having some difficulty recording the cars.
Sounds like my car, same like that. Mothballs.
Sorry.
No, you're fine now.
Iron block. 427. Ay, ay, ay. Wouldn't it be nice, huh, to own one of these? Like the 290 horse, underrated. Complete restoration. I think I just passed him. I believe that's Parker from Backyard Barn Finds. Thousand original miles. Seven. I'm sorry, go ahead. Wow. That looks really nice in that color. Wow. That is crazy nice. I don't think the camera's picking that up, but the color on that car is incredible. It's a gray color, like a gunmetal gray. Every nice Camaro left in the country is here. Well, at least quite a few of them anyway. Concourse condition survivors. Brown collar. How sharp is that? God. Oh, there's one. Same thing. So Jerry McNeish told me, I did not know that, but that box sitting on the console is an 8-track stereo. I've never seen that before until I saw the one in his car. Big block, 396. 325 horse, not the L78, if I have that correct. Colors on these cars in here are absolutely incredible. Olympic gold, SSRS, wow, another big block car. Not sure if you can see all that with the glare while you're looking at the motor here. I'm just filming stuff on the dash. Wow. Who's the owner? You?
That guy right there.
You're the owner?
Yeah. The guy in the north and the
this plant, is
the guy who built it.
Absolutely beautiful. The color's phenomenal. Absolutely beautiful. Now you put it together? Is that what he was saying?
Yeah.
You built it? Owned it from original? Found it? Put it together?
I found it in Carlisle.
That's a swap meet.
4 years ago.
Okay.
It was actually in the auction, but it wasn't the shape it's in now.
Yeah, yeah.
It was much better. There was a lot of things that they took shortcuts on that we've been improving for the past 4 years. And
wow. It's like a Holy Grail type car. 396,
yeah.
RS, SS. Olympic gold.
And I have paperwork that goes back to the original owner. So.
Documented on top of it?
Yeah.
That's why it's sitting in here then. Nice. That's a beautiful car. I didn't notice it right away as I was tinkering around, but wow, when I come up here, it stuck out. You don't find many in the Olympic gold that look like this.
No, it's an odd color, but I was very attracted to it when I found it, so.
I can see why.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's really nice. I'm just jealous of all you guys having these nice cars. There's so many of them. You're like, I want that.
Yeah, I could go back in time and buy them up. Yeah.
Yeah, if you knew what you had way back when compared to what you have now.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm a huge Gen 1 fan, especially this. I don't think there's a car ever built that has the lines of a 69 Camaro. In my opinion, the best lines you can find.
Firebird and the Camaro.
Well,
they're pretty
same
similar,
thing.
But yeah, the body styles were really attractive. I think all those guys were smoking dope when they were trying to draw this out, anyways. So I mean, I don't think
my Barracuda had the best lines on the car.
I don't know how they come up with it. Well, you're a Mopar guy.
No, it was like this. It was the same style. It looked like it was actually moving.
Sitting still.
It looked like it, like a car is supposed to look like. You know what I mean? Had a nice, a little in back. I don't have that car anymore, but I wish I had that car.
There's just something about the lines of this car
when they came out,
a kid, you get attracted to it, and then you just never forget it.
Yeah.
There's something about that attraction you find as a kid, and then you're like, damn, man, what a beautiful car. That color he's got, that's something else.
Some people have no idea where the car comes from.
I just enjoy looking at them. I like hearing the stories about them. You know, you just can't beat that kind of thing. All right, I'm going to keep looking.
Yep,
but thank you, though. Oh, sorry.
I would still take this.
Yeah, well, this is more popular. As your turquoise is very rare, I probably like it.
Another 302 with the two 4-valve carburetors. White houndstooth interior. Daytona yellow. These things are just way too nice. You part of this one?
She's part of this one, I'm part of her.
There you go.
And
well,
the real one, he went to the bathroom.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, you get a smile on your face when you fire these up, man. The chambered exhaust is something else, isn't it?
I got one like this that got wet on top.
I walk down the rows, I'm like, I want that one.
Yep.
Well, this particular model year to me is the absolute ultimate.
Oh, absolutely.
The lines can't be beat by any car that's been manufactured prior to or after.
Nope.
It's just, but that's us. That's our generation. You know, these kids now like these Ricers and those Bumblebee cars that I can't stand.
Yeah, they want to take the engine out and put a hop it up.
Turbo, a four-cylinder.
Yeah.
On top of the fact that there's no real men anymore. They're all young kids. They're not even men, you know what I mean? It's just, but these things are just so nice. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Jesus, this one's brown, incredibly looking. New Yorker. So we just had a little talk there with Parker from Backyard Barn Finds. And he's doing his thing. What a great day. Well, hey, everybody. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.